Let me get a little filming.
All right. I'm not going to talk unless there's people to talk to.
That's fine. I'll erase it.
I came here today to tell you about Jesus Christ. I want to tell you how to get into heaven. But I've been surprised to learn that some people do not want to go to heaven. And that's okay with me. If you don't want to go to heaven, I'm not going to twist your arm. But I'm trying to find those people who do want to go to heaven. If you're one of those people who wants to go to heaven, I'm going to tell you how to get there. There's only one way. Jesus Christ is the way. Jesus Christ is the only way. Now, I'm not telling you my opinion today. I'm telling you the words of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one can come to the Father except through me. Now, that's pretty plain English. Jesus said he's the only way you can get into heaven. So if you don't want to go to heaven, that's okay with me. But if you want to go to heaven, you need Jesus Christ. There is no other way. We all need Jesus Christ because we've all sinned. That's what the Bible says. All have sinned. That means every one of us, including me. And that's why we're all in trouble with God. Did you realize you're in trouble with God because of your sin? The Bible says the wages of sin is death. Because of our sin, we'll die and go to hell. But there's one way to fix that problem, only one way. Put your faith in Jesus Christ. Jesus came down from heaven. He became a man, and he died on a cross so your sins could be forgiven. At the very moment that you believe Jesus Christ is your Savior, at the very instant you have a heartfelt belief that Jesus paid for your sins on that cross, then it's true, your sins are forgiven. You don't have to go to hell because Jesus Christ paid for your sins. Rather than going to hell, you'll have eternal life in heaven. That's why we're here today. We want you to know how to get into heaven. Now, I can't make you believe. I can't tie you down and force you to believe, but I can tell you the good news. Even though we are sinners, Christ died for us. Isn't that good news? Do you love anyone enough that you would die for them? Does anyone love you enough they would die for you? That's what Jesus Christ did for you. The Bible says even though we're sinners, Christ died for us. Do you know how much God loves you? The Bible says God loves you so much, he gave his only begotten son. Do you know his name? His name is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ became a sacrifice on a cross. Jesus Christ died on a cross so your sins could be forgiven. The Bible says if you put your faith in Jesus, if you rely entirely on Jesus Christ for your salvation, if you believe Jesus' death on the cross serves as a full payment for all your sins, the Bible says it's true. Your sins are forgiven at that very moment. The Bible says you won't perish in hell. You won't have to go to hell to pay for your sins because Jesus paid for them himself. It says rather than going to hell, you'll have eternal life in heaven. Eternal life in heaven. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So that's why I'm here today. I want to ask you, do you want to receive the gift of eternal life in heaven? Do you want to receive the gift of eternal life in heaven? Do you want to receive the gift? You have it? Do you believe Jesus is your Savior? I'm going to see you in heaven someday. See, that's all God requires of us, faith in Jesus Christ. God makes it very easy. Believe on Jesus Christ and you will be saved. I'm not going to make it any harder than that. I'm not going to require you to become a religious person, join a religion, repent of all your sins, jump through all kinds of religious hoops. I don't want to put you under religious bondage, because Jesus Christ said all the work that God requires of you to do is believe on Him. Will you do it? Will you put your faith on Jesus Christ? Jesus said, if you don't believe in Him, you'll die in your sins. I don't want you to die in your sins. Amen. I'll see you in heaven, sir. You know what happens if you die in your sins? It means you can't get into heaven, because no sin's allowed in heaven. You can't go to heaven as long as you've got those sins. So I'm going to tell you how to have your sins forgiven. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Put your faith entirely on Jesus. Now, some of you believe in Jesus, but you don't believe Jesus is enough. You think you've got to become a religious person. You think that you must also attend church, confess to your priest, light the candles, worship the Virgin Mary. The Bible says, at the very minute you add any other requirements, if you think you can justify yourself to God through your religious works, it says you're alienated from Christ. You don't have the grace of God. You're not saved, because you're not relying on Christ entirely.